Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about internal working of HashMap in Java. What is an HashMap? HashMap is one of the most popular collection classes in Java, and HashMap extends abstract map class, and the abstract map class implements the map interface. HashMap is mainly used to store the key and an associated value to it, and we usually call it as a key value pair. In HashMap, duplicate values are allowed, but duplicate keys are not allowed. And in HashMap, order of entries is not preserved, meaning we insert some entries into the HashMap, right? So there is no guarantee that we actually get while reading the HashMap, right? So there is no guarantee that we get the entries in the same insertion order. Now let us see an example on HashMap. I'm going to have an HashMap object with key value pair as key as string, and my value is going to be integer. I'm going to name my object as map and instantiate with the new object of HashMap. String and integer is my key, right? Now, how to insert an element into the HashMap? So for that, we use put method, put key. I'm going to have my string as Mahesh and value as some 10. And I'm going to insert some other entry where I'm going to have my key as Suresh and then value as 20. We'll have one more entry where my key will be Madhu and value some 30, right? So this is how we can insert the elements into the HashMap. And how to read the element in HashMap. So we need to provide the key here. So let me provide the key here and let's display this on the console. Using the get method, we can actually read the value of the hash, like an element in the HashMap using the key. So you can see here, the associated value should be displayed now, and we can see the associated value displayed here, right? And how about like if we wanted to read all the entries in the HashMap? For that, we can use the for each loop where we can have an entry set method which gives us all the entries. And for each entry, we are going to iterate it. We are going to iterate and going to display the both keys and values. Right, m dot get key gives us the key, and from the entry we are going to use the get value method to get the value. And you can see we can actually read the values here, and if you observe the order was different. So the order which we inserted was Mahesh, Suresh, Madhu, but you can see the order differs in the output while reading. So this is what we mean by the order of the insertion is not preserved, right? Now, let us see how this works internally. This is all done, right? HashMap, yeah. We'll discuss what structure is. So the structure of the HashMap is, it has a node class with key and value in it. And this is a static inner class within the HashMap class. And it has the following attributes: an hash variable, which is of integer type, and it is final, a key, which is final again, and a value. And at last, we have a node reference within itself. This is the structure of the HashMap attributes. We need to understand some terminology before we go into the internal working of HashMap. So a bucket. Bucket is an element of an HashMap array. So you can see this is an HashMap array. Let's consider if this is an HashMap array, each element is called a bucket. And the default size of an HashMap is 16. We can actually specify the size. If not mentioned, then the default size of the HashMap is 16. Default size is 16 and the default load factor is 0.75, which means that the load factor decides when to increase the HashMap array. That is, the load factor, it is like when it is, the default size is 0.75, right? So once 12 elements are filled, then the size is doubled. So it is increased to 32. in this case, right? And each bucket can have more than one node. So how we are going to have more than one node in each bucket, we are going to see that in few minutes. This is about bucket. And we need to know the equals method. Equals method is a method which is defined in an object class. And as every class, either directly or indirectly, extends object class. So equals method is available for all the classes. And it is used to check if two objects are equal or not. And in HashMap, we are going to use this equals method to compare the keys and return, and which returns true if they are equal, otherwise it is going to return false. And we also going to use the another method called hashCode, which is also present in the object class. Actually, these are present in the object class, so we can actually override these methods. So hashCode method is used to get the hashCode of an object, that is the memory reference of an object. And in HashMap, how we are going to use hashCode is, we are going to use it to calculate the hashCode for the key, and thereby we are going to calculate the index for it to choose the bucket for the node. This is the basic terminology we need to have before we proceed to the internal working of HashMap, right? Now let us see how HashMap works internally. So let's take the same example which we saw just now. So a bucket size, a default bucket size is 16. And we are wanted to insert an entry into it, right? Map.put key comma value. So the first thing what is done is an hash code is calculated for the key. Though the logic for generating the hash code for the key in the actual HashMap class is different, for simplicity, let us take that. Let us calculate the hash code for the key as the ASCII code of the first character in the key. So in this case, we are going to have the ASCII code for M, which is 77. That is the hash code of key. And then we are going to calculate an index using the hash function, where we are going to have hash of key. And we are going to consider the bucket size minus one. And N is here is bucket size, N minus one. And we are going to have the binary AND for these two values. And why are we going for the index? Why can't we use the hash code itself to choose the bucket for the node? Right, that's the question. But if you observe, hash code for the key here is 77. So in some cases, the value of the hash code might actually exceed the bucket size. So how to resolve this? That's the reason we are going to have an index, which makes sure that always the index will be within the range of 0 to n minus 1, n being the bucket size. So let's go back. Now you can see the example here, right? The hash code for our key, current key is 77, and n is 16, the default size of bucket, and 15. So the when we do binary AND of 77 and 15, we get the index as 13. Now we are going to insert this entry into the 13th index. As we can see the structure of the hash map, right? So it has the hash, second key, value, and the node itself. So we don't have the reference to the any node. So we have it as null now. Now let us insert another entry, Suresh 20, right? So in the same way, we are going to calculate the hash code for the key as the ASCII code for, so sorry, it should be S here. It is 83, ASCII code of S is 83, and index is calculated as 3. So in the index 3, we are going to have this entry, right? And in the same way, we are going to have the third entry as well. So, but if you observe, this third entry has the same hash code as the first entry, right, Mahesh. So in this case, index will also be 13. So how do we resolve this hash code collision, right? So we already have an entry in the 13th index, but now we wanted to enter another entry into the hash map in the same index, right? How do we actually resolve this hash collision is, so here, what we'll do is we'll have it in the same index, and then whatever may be the first element in the index, so we are going to have its node value referred to the current entry. So similar to a single linked list. That's how you can actually imagine, right? This is how the elements are inserted in case of an hash collision. And if we have any more entries coming with the same index 13, then we'll have the node reference in the current element so that it refers to the next node, right? So this is how we can insert the entries into the hash map. And in the same way, we are going to read the values as well. For example, if you wanted to read the entry Suresh, right? So map.get of Suresh, then how does it work internally? So it actually again calculates the hash code 83, index is, will be like 83 and 15, 3. So it actually goes to 3, third index, and from third index, the first thing what is done is like the key is compared with the key in this index. Index key is Suresh, right? Suresh is compared with Suresh. So if both are equal, then the corresponding value is written, that is 20. If both are not equal, it will actually return a null value. And let's take another example. If you wanted to get the value for key Madhu, right? Right, map.get of Madhu. So the hash code will be calculated in the same way, and we are going to get the index 13. Now let's see. So if you observe, Madhu will be compared with this element in the 13. So it has Mahesh, right? So Madhu is compared with Mahesh, which is not equal. Then this will be verified, node will be verified. If node is not null, yes, node is not null, and it has some reference to another node next, right? So then it actually verifies the next node. In the next node, again, the key is compared with equals method with Madhu equals Madhu. Yes, it is equal this time, right? So it returns the value 30, and there are no more nodes to traverse, right? So even if this doesn't match, so this will be actually we verify the node reference, and if it is null, we return null. But in this case, it matched, so we are going to return the value as 30. So this is how HashMap works internally in Java. So in this video, we discussed about what is an HashMap, how we can insert elements into HashMap, how we can read the elements in it, and how HashMap works internally. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.